Hello, I'm Mr. R. Rijer, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. My late father knew this subject. He too was a bachelor of science, never studied theology in a university or anything, but intuition brought him a lot of treasures, which I'm sharing with you today. So this is a foreword to my book, First Gnostic Principles of One God, One Faith, and this is video number 2. People shouldn't study the chosen people, for they are the nation of priests, the moral teachers. The chosen people, you know, were planted by Yahweh into a promised land. Like if is a new Adam, Adam and Eve, Sarah was Eve, Abraham was Adam, and that was a demonstration nation and a model for other people to follow. Those who went by their model, they enjoyed the fruit of the land which belonged to Adam. And Yahweh is the one who is the creator of man. So he looks after his creation. Even in this dry desert, you will find life. If that life belongs to Yahweh. So if you can look after that in the dry land, why not in the green land where the man lives? So you learn a lot from their history. When they are faithful to Abraham, they live in the promised land and enjoy the best fruit in the world. But when they are unfaithful to Abraham, no salt of it, as they killed Jesus, which Abraham loved to see. So they were thrown out of the promised land, and after 2000 years, they are being brought back for the final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. All I have described, so just giving you recap. Today, they are Jews outwardly and are getting bundled up in Israel for the final burning, expected soon after May 2018. When Israel is going to be 70 years old. So we are in the tribulation period, and there shall be a lot of upheaval in the world. Gospel lightens up your path. It's like a torch. You can lighten up your path, and then you can walk safely, so that you have nothing to fear of. Although gospel is as simple as ABC, but many have no interest in it. You know, people are sensible, they are everything, but they go for money and clever things, seeking their own praises, not glorifying our Father. So they then apply their own formulas, own rules, and not go by the will of our Father. So then they suffer. But many have no interest in it. Psychic, you know, they don't like gospel. They like the praises of men, not of our Father God. They go by the dead scriptures. Living gospel is not there in the books, but it is within your own heart. When you have pondered over New Testament logically. That is why Christ Thomas said gospel would be known to 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji said 1 in 1,000,000. Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji was the last light in Sikhism. He was the number 6 Satguru. But most of these Sikhs, they don't know the difference between a guru and a Satguru. Guru is the rabbi, moral teacher. Satguru is the one who gives gospel to your mind. This being the dark age, in which all the three religious qualities, truth, contentment and mercy, disappears among the majority of people, and only those who have conscience and are predestined, twice born, would long for gospel, whilst the rest will go for the sugar-coated sermons of falsehoods called kood in Punjabi, delivered by the crook, twice-born psychics. Thus the world is full of the clever psychic fake antichrist who seek their own praise rather than glorifying our Father as the solitary nomadic preachers of gospel do in honor of Christ Jesus and Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. About the fake Satguru Nanak Dev Ji said, Nanak te nar asal khar ye bin gun grab granth. A person is a super donkey carrying holy books. If he is a fake, he doesn't understand what the scripture says, but he just repeats it like a parrot, then he is a super donkey. This book is dedicated to my parents and my bosom friend, late Jasmer Hans, who got my Punjabi book, Kakh Ole Lakh, printed from Ludhiana, Punjab, you know. He helped me to get it printed. Many people refuse to do it, you know, because they say, you know, it is too aggressive and too outspoken, you know. So, temple of the Most High God, our supernatural Father, Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim, etc., the hospital for the spiritually sick people, was built in Amritsar for the people of Lahore and Amritsar, were great hypocrites. So people of the Lahore and Amritsar were great hypocrites. That's why this golden temple is built between them. So Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji said, Amritsar ye, andar sadiye. They are worse crook or hypocrites. They are worse hypocrites than those of Banaras, the Jerusalem of India. I have got two books published, one in English, the first Gnostic Principles of One God, One Faith, in 1993, and the other in Punjabi, Kakh Ole Lakh, in 2005. The English one was printed in Park Royal, England, whilst the Punjabi one was twice printed by two unreliable printers in the Punjab. I have put the over there the story how they cheated me. One book to one printer, I gave £1,800, more than that. And he promised to send 5,000 books with his magazine, and I got not a single reply from anyone, not a single. And he say, oh, people are like that. In other words, he did not print 7,000. He printed less. Charged me 7,000 plus postage, £1,800. And the other one, there was a Sharma family living in near Reading. He was doing travel agency as I was doing, so we were friends, very close friends. So I told them that I need this book printed. Oh, no problem, my brother can get it printed, his wife said. I said, that's good, you know, if your brother can do it. So I went to them and gave them £1,500 cash. I did not bother to get any receipt. And they won't print it. And getting fed up, you know, then I arranged with one Janmeja Johor of Ludhiana, who said he will print it for me. And he then print 7,000 and 5,000, he said, he sent to the people with his general, no response. And this Sharma Crook, he won't publish it. And when I told him, can I get my money back? Then I think he did it very hastily and very poor print. And then they asked me, oh, it was more than, you know, what money you gave me. And they told me that you did not give us 1,500, you gave us 1,200. So £300, they cheated me here. And then poor work. So this is the mentality of the Punjabi and Indian, you know, of the Punjab. South Indian are far better because they have conscience. The people of the Punjab have no conscience. They are the Punjab is the epicenter of the crooks. So this time I'm not going to get anything printed from there unless I get very, very reliable source. So this my bosom friend was the one who helped me, and still the crook went through it. They stole the money. So I will leave it here and we will do the next video then.